everybody on the Pro Forum. So I want to talk lighting. Kind of a technical thing. It's kind of a personal preference thing. But again, I feel like if we can be the expert, if we can have as much technique under our belt, the better it will be in the long run when it comes to being a professional photographer and competing with the mass market out there. Now, if you look at the mass markets, people are getting into the business and they don't know diddly squat about studio lighting. And that is because it is so easy to simply take a digital camera, walk outside, plop somebody underneath a tree, plop a flash on top of the camera. The camera does all the thinking for you. Start shooting. It focuses for you. It adjusts exposure. It gives you just a little bit of fill. I mean, goodness, it produces a darn good result just like that. I mean, if you just happen to find a little bit of good directional light, bam, you are in business producing pretty darn good images. Everybody likes to be outside, so for that reason, they end up with pretty darn good stuff and they get to charge hardly anything for it. They got a camera, they've got a flash, they've got a little lens and a laptop, and boom, they are in business. They make some CDs, make a little 20 bucks here, a little 50 bucks there, and they are doing it on the side. Beautiful. All right. Well, what if we could do something even better? For example, knowing studio lighting and understanding how like a 4x6 softbox works, and that it's just basically a big monster light source. It's kind of like reproducing what you see outside, and it reproduces the effects of what open shade does. That's one of the first and most easiest things to get past. I use the Denny Manufacturing 4x6 because you can pick this thing up for very inexpensive. I think it's like $299 or $399. It pops open like an umbrella. It sets up within seconds. It's the kind of thing that you can go portable. You can take it to someone's house. You can take it, you can put it in your garage. You can collapse the thing and put it in the corner. It's very, very awesome. It's very durable. I've only owned one and I beat my equipment up. And all I ever do with the thing is I point it at the subject and I try to make sure that I'm hitting the forehead with light, the two cheeks, down the nose, and the chin. That's it. If those five areas, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 areas of the face are being hit with light, if there's no spill, like if the light is coming from here and there's no spillover of light, if I don't see light on this ear, great, I'm in the right position. If the light is coming from this side and there's no spillover, if I see light spilling around and it's touching this ear, then the light needs to move so that you don't get spillover on the opposite ear from where the light is. That's it. That's the most basic of basic lighting that there is, and that will get you going in the right direction. Now, what does that do for us? Well, it gives us another layer of opportunity, another layer of producing images that is better than what anybody else can do. When it comes to high school senior portraits, I know it's all about variety, and if you can get one outfit inside, two outfits outside, well, then you're producing variety. It could be a simple black background. You could throw a light back there, make it gray, make it white, add a little colored gel to it, change that up. Denny Manufacturing, they make incredible, crazy freedom cloth backgrounds. There's just a ton of those things available. They always have a sale going on. So it's pretty basic and simple to be able to be in the studio lighting business without a lot of money and without a lot of complexity, and thus what you end up with is being able to do things that the other guys just can't do. So think about that. If you're not already doing that, great. If you are, then that's even great too. So that's just a little bit of a message for the day. I hope that helps someone. Talk to y'all tomorrow. Bye-bye.